Hello there, Mr. Sutton here with the IM3 Honors 7-7 Extra Practice Number 1 Solutions on Sine and Cosine Curves.
To graph this function, let's first begin by finding the amplitude and period. The amplitude is going to be the coefficient of the trig function, so there's an invisible 1 out here. That's our amplitude, A. For the period, I have to do 2 pi divided by this B value. That's the coefficient of the variable inside the trig function. So I need to do 2 pi divided by 2/3. And doing a little same change flip, this is really 2 pi times 3 over 2. Let's see here. So 2's are going to cancel. So that's 3 pi altogether. Now to put this on a graph. So since my amplitude is 1 and I'm centered on the x-axis, because this is just a normal trig function, no shift or anything, I'm going to put a 1 up here for the y scale, and I've divided this up into 4 different pieces, and on the 4th hash mark, I'm going to put a 3 pi. That'll give me my 4 kind of phases that my trig function is going to go through. All right, since this is sine, we are beginning in the middle here, going up. So we've got one point here on the origin, and then we just go up and then down the amplitude and one step over. So we're going to take one step over and go one up, one step over, one down, one step over and down again, and then up, and then we just draw the sine curve through those points. To graph this function, let me begin with the amplitude and period. The amplitude is this number out here in front of the trig function, the coefficient there. The period is going to be 2 pi divided by this coefficient of x in here. So that's going to be 2 pi over 10, which we can reduce to pi over 5. And now to put all this on a graph, I'm going to go up and down the amplitude. So let me set my y scale here. I'll make this go by 2.5s, so then I just need to go up and down by one grid line. And then I need to go a total of pi over 5 to go through the entire 4 cycles of my wave. So I'll split the horizontal up into 4 different pieces, and on the 4th I'll put pi over 5. So I've got 4 even pieces here. So now I just need to take one step over and one step up or down in order to draw my trig function. Now since I'm dealing with cosine, that begins at the top of the wave. So on the far left, on the beginning of my wave, I'm going to start at the top here, 2.5, and then I'm going to go down a step as I take one step over. And then I'll go down again until I hit the bottom here, and then I just bounce back up. So one step over, one step over, step up, and then draw the cosine curve smoothly through those points. To sketch this cosine graph, I'm going to start by finding the amplitude and period. For the amplitude, that's the coefficient of the trig function. So this invisible 1 out here is our amplitude. That means we're going up and down 1 from the midline of this graph. The period is going to be 2 pi divided by whatever the b value in here is. So we've got 1/4 being multiplied by the variable in there. So we're doing 2 pi divided by 1/4 to get the period. And then same change flip, we're really doing 2 pi times 4 over 1, so 8 pi. All right, now to graph all this out. So I'll put 1 on a grid line here. That way I just have to go up and down one grid line as I move to the right. And let's see here, I need 4 different parts of my trig graph to draw these. So I'm going to divide this into 4 equal pieces and stick 8 pi on the end, because it takes 4 parts to go through a full cycle of my cosine wave. All right, so now I just have to take one step over and one step up or down in order to draw this thing. Since it's cosine, we're beginning at the top of the wave, so that's going to be right here. We're going between negative and positive 1, so the top is 1. And then I take one step over and I have to take one step down, one step over, and I keep going in that downward direction until I hit the bottom here. Then I'm going to bounce back up as I take a step to the right, and I'll keep going up until I hit the ceiling there. And then I can draw my cosine curve through those points. Before I go ahead and draw this cosine curve, let me get the amplitude and period. The amplitude is this 3/4 coefficient of cosine. That's how much I'm going up and down for every step I take to the right. The period is going to be 2 pi divided by whatever's being multiplied by the x here. So 2 pi over 4, which I can reduce to pi over 2. So to draw this, I'm going to make my y scale go by 3/4, which seems like kind of a weird number, but if I do this, then I go exactly one grid line up or down for every step I take to the right. And to make sure that I only have to take one step to the right to go through each quarter of my cosine wave, I've split this up into 4 equal pieces, and I'm going to put my whole period, pi over 2, at the very end. So now we've got 4 quarters of this pi over 2 period that we're going through. So because I've got cosine, that means I start at the top of the wave. So on the far left here, I'm going to start at 3/4. That's the top of the wave. The bottom of the wave is going to be negative 3/4 on the other end here. So I take one step to the right. This is whatever a quarter of pi over 2 is. I guess that would be pi over 8. So we go pi over 8 to the right and then down. And then one step to the right and down. And then we have to step up because we've hit the bottom of the wave. And one step to the right and up. And then draw my cosine curve through those. To draw this sine wave, let me start by getting the amplitude and period. So for the amplitude, I've got this 2 out in front of the function. That's how much I'm going up and down for every step I take to the right. And then for the period, I have to divide 2 pi by whatever this b value in here that's being multiplied by the x is. So 2 pi over pi over 3 is what's going on there. Doing a little same change flip, we've got 2 pi times 3 over pi. Pi's cancel, we just end up with 2 times 3, which is 6. All right, I'm going to graph this out now. I'm going to do vertical grid lines that are going by 2s so that I can take exactly one step up or down for every step I take to the right. And then for my period, to get through the whole wave, I have to go a distance of 6. And there's 4 parts of the wave. So I'm going to chop this up into 4 equal pieces and then put a 6 on the fourth. So each of these now is a quarter of this period. So because I've got sine, I have to start in the middle of my wave and then go up. So I start here and then I take one step over and up. And I'm at the top of the wave now, so there's nowhere to go but down as I take another step to the right. And I keep going in that direction again until I hit the bottom of the wave here. Then I bounce back up as I take another step. And I've got the whole wave drawn out, one whole period at least. It's not the whole wave, but it's a period of it. It's enough. So we'll draw the sine wave through those points. And we're done with this one. To draw this cosine function, let me begin with the amplitude, which is 1/2. And the period, which is going to be 2 pi divided by whatever I'm multiplying by x, which is also 2 pi. So 2 pi over itself then gives us 1. So to graph this out, I'm going to put my amplitude of 1/2 as the vertical scale here. We're going by 1/2. That way I can just take one grid line step up or down every time I step to the right. Now for my horizontal, I'm going to put a 1 at the very end here. And notice that I've chopped this whole period up into 4 equal parts. Because every step I take with my wave, I'm going through a quarter of the period. There's like 4 phases to this thing. All right, so now because I got cosine, I'm starting at the top of the wave, which is 1/2. And then I take one step right and down, and I keep doing that until I hit the bottom of the wave at negative 1/2. Then I bounce back up, one step over, one step up, over and up. And this is a whole period here. We made it that way. So let me just graph those, connect the dots here basically with a nice cosine curve, and call this one done.